So guys, before starting our digital marketing course, in this video I'll tell you what is marketing, because if you don't know basics of marketing, you can't be a digital marketing expert. So guys, in this video I'll answer two questions. The first question is, what is marketing? And the second question is, what is difference between a good marketer and a great marketer? So firstly guys, I will tell you what is marketing. So guys, I will do one thing, I'll just give you an example of marketing, then we will cover this topic in detail. Suppose guys, you'll go to supermarket, you will see two products there. On the one product, means both products are same, on one product it's written juice and on the second product it's written fresh fruit juice. So which one you will buy? So you'll definitely buy where it is written fresh fruit juice. So this is marketing. Guys, I will show you one more example of marketing, how companies are doing marketing nowadays. I'm on google.com. I have typed hotels in New Delhi. So it will display many ads. You will see hotels in Delhi from 765 rupees. Means in the same way you will see fabhotels.com. They are providing 40% off. Means this is how they are doing marketing of their business. They are providing some kind of discounts. And if you will go to, means I type men blazers, you will see up to 50% off on men blazers, means up to 50% off. And the third thing is, if you'll go to facebook.com, you will see many ads there. On the right side you will see domains for rupees 99. You can purchase a domain at rupees 99 from godaddy.com. In this way they are promoting their business. Means they are making people aware about their product. So this is marketing. Means how you visualize your product in front of customers. So this is marketing. Now guys, I'll explain you in detail what is marketing. So guys, when it comes to marketing, most of people think it's about sales or it's about promotions, but it is more than that. Means it varies from business to business. Your business is B2B or your business is B2C. So firstly, I'll explain you about B2B business. As you can see my screen.
So guys, for the B2B business, we will take example of bankbazaar.com. So means they are doing business for the other businesses. Like if you want to apply for the home loans or for the personal loan, I click on it. They will provide me data of different companies. Means you can compare the plans here. So I'll click on get a quote. So it will ask for my data. Like I'll click on next. So I need to click on my gender. Then after that I'll enter my city. So once you will fill the details, means you will enter your data, they will ask for your details like your name, your mobile number and for your email address. So whenever you will enter your data, they will give this data to the other banks or finance companies. So means they are doing business for other businesses. So their marketing strategy will be different. So means their focus will be on lead generation, not on the direct sales. So this is example of B2B business. And if you want to take example of B2C business, you can just go to any e-commerce website, because they are selling their product directly to their customers. So means if you want to select any product, you can just go there and you can select it, and that's it. Means they're selling the product directly to the customers. So means you can select any product and you can buy it. So this is, means their marketing strategy will be different. They will provide some kind of discount code, some kind of loyalty program, so that they will attract more customers. But on the other hand, B2B business, their marketing strategy will be different. They just want customers to enter the data for other businesses. So this was about like how you should create your marketing strategy, what is your business and what are the requirements of the customers and how you will fulfill them according to your business.
So guys, you have seen both examples. So guys, the main thing is, if you want to understand marketing, firstly you need to understand the requirements of the customers. Means you need to understand the needs of customer. It doesn't matter what is your product, the thing matters is what are the requirements or what are the needs of customer, and is your product is fulfilling those needs or not. So guys, I will do one thing, I'll use 4 P's of marketing in order to explain it in a better way. So the first P is product, second P is price, third P is place, and fourth P is promotion. So firstly I'll talk about the product. So product means your product is fulfilling the needs or requirements of the customer or not. Guys, you know that nowadays people use mobile phones or laptops. Suppose I will launch a product which is a very big computer, so it will work? No, it will not, because my product is not fulfilling the needs of customer. So it will not work. So the next thing is price, means how much price I am charging for that product. Suppose I have launched a mobile phone with 2 GB of RAM and 10 GB of 10 megapixels of camera, means these kind of specifications, and I am charging so much amount for it. Suppose my competitor is charging 5,000 Indian rupees and I am charging 7,000 Indian rupees or 10,000 Indian rupees for the same configuration. So do you think it will work? No, it will not, because I am charging too much money. My product is so much expensive, so people will not buy it. So this was about pricing, means how you set your pricing, how you set your pricing according to your competitors. And the third P is place. Guys, place is not just about where you sell your product. It's about transportation, it's about inventory, and it's about sales as well. First, we will take the example of transportation. Guys, you can take example of big factories. You will see most of big factories will be on the outer part of the city, because it will be easy for them to transfer their goods from one place to another. Now guys, we'll talk about the sales. Guys, you can take example of yourself. Suppose you want to open a restaurant. So what you will do, firstly, you will check entire city, means you will do survey of entire city, and then you will decide where should I open my restaurant so that I'll get maximum sales. So now you can understand means how place is important for the sales of your business. And the fourth P is promotion, how you promote your product. You can just take the example of most of the website. They're giving some discount codes, they're giving some loyalty programs. And we can take one more example of promotion. As we discussed it before, you're going to supermarket and you will see two products there. On one product it's written juice, and on the second product it's written fresh fruit juice. So you will definitely buy fresh fruit juice. So this is promotion, how you promote your product, how you visualize your product in front of customers. So guys, if you will cover all these things, then you will become a good marketer. Means you have right product, you have launched it on the right time, you have right price, you are promoting it in the right way, but you are a good marketer. If you are a good marketer, what is the difference between a good marketer and a great marketer? Great marketers create the needs of customers. We can take the example of some online websites. If you'll buy any product, suppose I'm buying a DSLR, means a camera. You will see in suggestions that you should buy tripod as well. So means they are creating my needs, like I have a camera, I should buy a tripod as well. In the same way, you can take example of supermarkets. If you'll go to supermarket to buy a toothbrush, and you will see some products near to that toothbrush. You will see toothpaste, you will see hand sanitizer, you will see soaps. Means if you're going for a toothbrush, you will definitely buy other items as well. Means there will be more chances. This is an example of great marketer, like how you create needs of customer, how you are selling those products to the customer which they were not their needs before. So this is example of a great marketer. They create needs of customer. Guys, I will give you one more example of marketing, which is indirect marketing. Means we do marketing for other companies or other products as well. Suppose my friend wants to buy a car, so I will recommend him buy this company, Mahindra, Ford car, like I'm using it from a long time and you should buy, their customer service is very good. So this what I'm doing means I'm doing marketing for these companies. So this is called indirect marketing. So guys, this was about marketing. If you still have any question about this topic, you can comment below this video. So guys, thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe my channel to get recent updates about my videos. So let's see in the next video.